Don't turn your channel. You're about to see part two of Everything's Gonna Be All Right. There's the conclusion of the message, and then you're going to get to enjoy all of the testimonies as people begin lining up and continuing to come down to just testify of what God did in their lives that night. So stay tuned. Don't turn your channel. Everything's going to be all right.
John 14, 27 says, "My peace I continually give to you." Amen. I said, everything's going to be all right. Amen. Now, how can I make such a statement? Everything's going to be all right. Satan is trying to steal your purpose and your identity. Amen. If you don't have any peace, you're not going to hold on to it. If you don't have peace, you're not going to work and operate in faith. I'm going to show you so clearly here that this is where a lot of our problem is tonight. If I can get you to see this and move into this, you should receive a lot of things from the Lord tonight. The peace of God will stabilize you. When you have peace and your heart's settled, and you aren't just beside yourself, but you have peace, then you can receive. If you don't have peace, you won't receive. When you get to the place that you can believe, we're talking about healing. When you get to the place, it's going to be all right. My God's going to take care of me. He is going to turn this thing around for me. He's going to help me see and help me by when I choose to believe him. Amen. So we're still back to what you're going to believe. Because you have to believe it.
Through Dr. Sandra Kennedy's brand new book, you will receive the supernatural keys that unlock the door for you to step into freedom from disease and step into the abundant life which Jesus provided for you.
It's time to start over. Our brand new book and 3-CD series, The Simplicity of Healing.
The Simplicity of Healing. For a donation of $35, shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9464. Call or write today.
As I have sworn in my wrath, if they shall enter into my rest, although the works were finished from the foundation of the world. You've been healed from the foundation of the world. How long have I been healed? Forever. From the beginning. For he spake in a certain place on the seventh day on this verse, wise, and God did rest the seventh day from all his works. And in this place again it shall, if they shall enter into my rest. Verse 6 of chapter 4. Seeing therefore it remaineth that some must enter therein, and they to whom it was first preached enter not because of unbelief. They could not be persuaded. That's what that word really says. They could not be persuaded to believe. Now, I'm doing everything in my power to persuade you tonight. I'm trying to go directly to your spirit to persuade you. There's nothing in your life to keep you except unbelief from receiving. You're hunting something that's already been given. You're going after, praying, please. Don't misunderstand me. We all do it because that's what the flesh does. And that's what your natural mind does. When you can't see it and you can't feel it and the pain's killing you, that's what you end up doing. But somewhere, God's bigger than this. This is going to be all right. Set a platform. This is going to be all right. Look at your neighbor and say, everything's going to be all right. Hallelujah. Verse 9, there remaineth therefore a rest to the people of God. For he that is entered into his rest, he also has ceased from his own works, as God did from his. When you start resting, you will quit striving. And you will start praising. Praising. Let us labor, therefore, to enter into that rest, lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief. Let's make sure we believe God. For the word of God is quick, powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and it's a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. The word of God. The word of God. The word of God. See, God already has every answer to every question you have. Who do we need? Him. We need Jesus. That's who we need. And we have the power to choose to trust in God. You got to get past the whys. Because when we get on whys, I can tell you, I've walked it many a time. When you get on whys, you become a victim. And when you get on whys, it's an invalid question. And it makes you an invalid. What does this mean? What must I do? That's what we should be asking. What does this mean? What is it I must do? Lord, what is it? What is it you're trying to say to me? What is it I must do? Don't let circumstances use you. Change how you see it. Run to Jesus. Don't hunt a prophetic word. Run to Him. His peace will give you vision, clear vision, vision of Him. Peace is critical to your spiritual health, your mental health, and your physical health. Peace, rest. Don't be like those who did not believe. Don't be like those who didn't believe. He has given us the power to believe. We can choose to believe. He may not do it the way you want it done. It doesn't matter how he does it. Just, I believe you're going to do it. You're going to do it. I choose to believe you're working in my body. I choose to believe I'm in recovery. Hands have been laid on me. I'm in recovery. And hell, you will not take my life. You will not make me an invalid. You will not steal from me my destiny and my purpose. You will not do that. I won't let you do that because I will praise God and I will praise God and I will praise God. And you will never make me not praise Him. I will praise Him and 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 I will praise Him. I will praise Him. He's worthy of all my praise. I will praise Him. So, Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we come to You tonight free. We need to rest. We need to rest. We need to be at peace that You have it. Left us, forgotten about us, that You aren't ashamed of us, that You are embarrassed of us. Forgive us for even thinking such terrible things. Those kind of things would never, ever come out of Your mouth. You would never say anything but wondrous things over Your beloved disciples. You honor them. You honor us. You want us to show forth Your glory and Your might. We come against the lies of hell. Yes. We break their power over us. Yes. Those who think they can't get up, get up. Yes. Those who think they can't walk, walk. Those who think that they have been absolutely invaded and encapsulated by the diseases of this world, burst out of it. Amen. Take your stand. Do it. Believe it. Rise up and be healed in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. Rest in Him. Find peace in Him. Be not afraid. He won't leave you. He won't forsake you. He's not in the dying business. He's in the living business. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's just praise Him. And 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 praise Him. Lord, let Your peace be over this congregation. Give people power and strength to trust You and step out and do what they couldn't do before they came in here. Let them put action to their faith. Encourage them. Take all fear away. All fear be gone. And we thank You, Lord Jesus. We praise You. Church, praise Him. We praise Him. We praise Him. We praise Him. Let's lift our hands to Him. Let's lift our hands to Him. That's such a higher way of praising. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him. Praise Him, praise Him. Praise Him, praise Him. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him. Glory to God. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Lord God. Now, I know God's in this place. Do what you couldn't do. Come tell me about it. Get up. Come tell me. Come tell me what God's done. Don't act like He hadn't done anything.
I've heard and I've heard and I've heard, but I know that tonight it's about the peace.
Yes.
It's the peace that's been the whole thing.
Yes.
I see it like I've never seen anything in my life.
Praise God.
Because the medical stuff would keep coming back. I better do this in the meantime. No, I don't. It's the peace, and I really got it.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Give Him praise. Come give Him praise. Thank You.
I'm the person from Maryland. I'm a pastor there, and the last 3 years have been a battle with my kidneys. Long story short, they began to shut down in 2016, and the Lord has been working in my body. I went into the cafe.
Yes.
Right there. I'm not supposed to eat salty food. Mm-hmm. And so I said,
wrong
said,
place
so
to
I,
go.
So I asked them, I said, you got anything that's low sodium? They said, no. I said, well, let me just do something the best I can. So I had the chicken.
Don't get us all hungry, brother.
My wife's probably watching right here. And I also had the casserole. And I said, well, I'm going to trust God with this. But my blood pressure has been going down consistently. And when I came back, I ate that, and it went down to 107 over 73. Now, and so before, when I would eat that, it'd go like to 170, go up higher, 180. But I have more energy. God is moving in my life. And just it's confirmation, because I was going to preach when I got back on resting in God. And I began the year with what you had said. God spoke to me in my prayer room. There will be a year of shock and awe. And He's been confirming that.
Hallelujah.
All night.
Hallelujah.
So I thank God.
Shock and awe.
Glory.
Glory. Glory. Glory. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah.
I got it. Hey. Just a lack of understanding, but I got it. I can rest in it. I can be assured of it because Woo. God has already done it by Pastor Kennedy. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I bought a book, Simplicity of Healing, and I went through it, and I'm saying, just a lack of understanding, but confirmation has, don't buy the lie.
Amen.
But glory be to God. I can rest in it. I got it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tell him. Don't sit back there and hold something God's done and not tell somebody. Come on.
I'm a cardiac sonographer by trade, and so I use my arm, my left arm, constantly. And a lot of times it burns, and I nurse it all the time. And today I was at work, and I was thinking about Pastor, and the word that you spoke when you said the title of the message.
Everything's going to be all right.
Everything's going to be all right came in my mind. And so, make a long story short, my arm was burning, been burning all day. I got to work, and I went to the gym. I was on the treadmill nursing this arm. I keep it on a jacket, and the Lord said, go to church. I said, okay, I'm going to church. And as I was just sitting there, it just doesn't burn or anything.
Hallelujah!
Of last year, I came to the Healing Center. I'd been diagnosed with breast cancer. And at that time, we claimed my healing June 21st, 2018. Last week, I got a clean report.
Glory to God.
I stepped in a hole in August and twisted my knee and tore some things. So it took a long time to figure out all that. In December, they operated on my knee with that microscope thing. And I was allergic to the medication later for the pain, so that didn't work. And it just felt like it was better, but then all of a sudden, it just hasn't been good. And I've had peace. Mm-hmm. I've been hearing all the same scriptures that we was talking mm-hmm. about tonight. I've been mm-hmm. hearing it all day in my spirit or on TV or whatever. And didn't plan on really being here tonight. And because I felt that it didn't feel, you know, it's hard walking. But it just all turned out and worked out, and I'm here, and I'm just, thank God, I don't have to have that thing, that cane or nothing. The pain was very bad.
Mm-hmm. But how's it now?
I don't have any. I sat down without it.
Yeah,
I sat down without the cane. I went to the back to make sure, you know, that everything's working.
Yeah, got you. And this thing out, yeah.
And then I sat down without the cane, then I got up without the cane, and I said, well, I'm doing, it's not my cane. I borrowed it. So I'm, you know,
give it back. You return it.
So I just thank the Lord, and I do thank him. He's been giving me peace, and I knew he's going to do something.
Well, he did it, didn't he?
He did.
Amen.
He did.
Amen.
He was diagnosed with cancer last year in March. Chemo drugs had tore his body up. He had every symptom there could be. The pneumonia, infection, blood clots, kidney shut down. And he laid up in the hospital bed, and the doctor kept coming to me. He said, he's a very sick man. He will not get over this. It's going to take a while. And as he laid up there in that bed, they transferred him from a room to ICU. He got worse. Monday came, and the doctor told the other doctor, he will not last past 2 days. He's too weak to last past 2 days. Something was blocking his airway. His lungs kept collapsing as he breathed. When they took him off that Monday, it became Wednesday, the 2 days. The doctor came in and said, whoo, let me listen to you. He said, I'm sending you to a room now. It came on, they had him bedridden. They wouldn't let him get up. And they said, well, you know, when you're bedridden, your body is not moving, so those muscles are limp. He began to, legs start moving, arms start moving. He said, I need to sit up on the side of his bed. So he started doing these things. They let him go. Uh-huh. He came home. They let him out on a Sunday. He was driving himself to Dallas on the Tuesday. Uh-huh. The clinical manager come to me. She said, you know what, Ms. Knight? She said, what's on the report? He doesn't look like what's on this report. She said, I asked the doctor. She said, I talked to Ms. Knight Monday to make sure that he still was in that spot. She said, can you tell me how is it, what we need to expect? She said he had his head down, and he rose up and said, miraculously well. Amen. He said, I don't understand, but miraculously well, he's
praise
doing.
Praise God.
Woo! Everything came all right. They let him go that night after Dallas that Friday. He drove home. And this is what my thing was, it was a lot of people, you know, why is he driving? But my thing is, if you prayed for a healing, mm-hmm. how come he can't drive? Mm-hmm. 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 So what's, you know, that was my problem. And that's what I asked. What's the problem? That's what I was talking about. Yes. Yes.
Well, we know he's healed just because he's been standing up
that's
here this whole
right.
time.
That's right. That's right. And he wanted to meet Joe, who spoke the word over him. And we came here about a month ago.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Can't leave.
And can't leave.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You are a miracle. Let the miracle man speak.
Yeah, I want to thank God for everything he did and the people that helped me through him. So I just say thank you and thank you.
Thank the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God.
Yes, yes, yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise God. That is a miracle. Anyone else?
I just want to thank God for the word that we've received since we've been here. My sister, Velda, Reverend Velda, last night when she spoke, not believing the lies. Also today about the hope deferred, just the word, and then your word tonight just sealed the deal. It's going to be all right.
It's going to be all right.
Because the enemy has attacked my husband's memory. He's just a bright man of God and everything, and I'm seeing that. So I'm standing and believing for my husband for so long.
Amen.
And a lot of times I've been looking at circumstances and all that, but when you said tonight to rest in him. And I got that, and I got that peace, no matter what it looked like, the circumstances.
Amen. Amen.
I'm going to stand.
We're staying with you, too.
Yes,
amen.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
I was diagnosed with stage 4 breast cancer. They thought I was going to die. Well, during the course of my chemo, I came to Sandra Kennedy Ministries. I couldn't eat. I lost 50 or 60 pounds. And the next day, I woke up, and my kids wanted to go to Greek Fest. I hadn't been able to eat anything. It was so painful to use the restroom. And so I started off. I went to the bathroom normally. I didn't think anything about it. Got to the Greek Fest, and I had lamb chop. And I then realized, oh my gosh, I'm healed. Hallelujah. Well,
glory.
I know. Now, this recently now, I woke up about a month and a half ago, and I don't know what happened. I woke up and I barely could crawl. And I have been in such terrible pain. I had my daughter, my granddaughter, and my other daughter, I had them anoint me with oil. And man, I had no pain. Then I called Sandra Kennedy Ministries. And listen, all I'm going to say is Jesus said, trust me. I came here tonight because I trust you, Jesus.
Amen.
You're going to have me walking just fine and no more pain. In the name of Jesus, I
Amen.
Trust you.
Amen.
I think that's what you were trying to say tonight, wasn't it?
Are you in pain now?
I have been.
No, I'm talking about right now.
A little.
This very minute. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh,
thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Woo!
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
Should be gone.
Thank you. Thank you.
What
it is. It is. Woo!
Praise God. Hallelujah. Woo! Yeah. Praise Him. Hallelujah.
The end of January, I had received this thing from the MRI that they said. Anyhow, about 3 weeks later, I was sitting in church on a Sunday, and the preacher started on Elijah. Well, about 30 years ago, when you first came on TV, it was like I saw you. And you said, "What is a Tishbite?" And it was like you were right there. I was seeing you, and the Lord said to come up here. And I just want to say, and on the way up, the two ministers that brought me, I brought my peace oil, my shalom oil, and we had gone somewhere else and anointing there. And I just want to say it was like that other gentleman. I've got it now, and the peace and the rest and everything you said, and just praise the Lord and praise God. So I can't wait to see what they do next.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Through Dr. Sandra Kennedy's brand new book, you will receive the supernatural keys that unlock the door for you to step into freedom from disease and step into the abundant life which Jesus provided for you.
It's time to start over. Our brand new book and 3-CD series, The Simplicity of Healing.
The Simplicity of Healing. For a donation of $35, shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9464. Call or write today.
I know you were blessed and encouraged by the testimonies. You know, there is power in the Word of God. It brings life and health and medicine to all of your flesh. And that was just living proof at that healing explosion as people came forward right after the teaching of the Word. There wasn't a prayer line, they just came because they got it and it dropped from their head into their hearts. You don't want to miss the next healing explosion, April the 25th and 26th, here at Whole Life Ministries in Augusta, Georgia.
Through Dr. Sandra Kennedy's brand new book, you will receive the supernatural keys that unlock the door for you to step into freedom from disease and step into the abundant life which Jesus provided for you.
It's time to start over. Our brand new book and 3-CD series, The Simplicity of Healing.
The Simplicity of Healing. For a donation of $35, shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9464. Call or write today.